Motorola, I forgot you even existed. I thought you never made smartphones anymore, but apparently yes. So Motorola dropped the Motorola Razr a week ago, and this still doesn't justify a phone. And yes, a lot of things I'm saying today is my personal preference. It's what I think of foldables in general. But I think it's a very hot topic and many people are talking about it. So here's my take on the Motorola Razr. Let's begin. So honestly, it's been so long since Motorola made a smartphone that actually got on that I was kind of shocked that Motorola suddenly just...
Yeah, there we go. Motorola Razr. It's a foldable phone.
And there are so many things different about this approach. And from my takeaway with the Galaxy Fold, I feel like this is just worse. I mean, but at least with the Galaxy Fold, they had a purpose for the Fold, okay? You could have a smaller phone that fits in your pocket, and then when you take it out, it's a 7-inch tablet, basically. However, with the Motorola Razr, it's really somewhere in the middle. It doesn't make sense. So first off, the Motorola Razr, it flips this way. So it flips from the top to the bottom, unlike the Galaxy Fold that opens up to the right and left sides. This closes up like a laptop lid, for example. And this is a very interesting and weird approach because first off, I thought the whole point of foldables was that you could fit in your pocket easier, and then when you take it out, have a huge display in a sense on non-foldable smartphones. But however, with the Motorola Razr, the bigger screen on the inside is 6.1 inches. Guess what else has more screen size than that? Well, iPhones, Galaxies, OnePlus. Heck, even Google has bigger screens on this. The phones I'm bringing up here are not even foldable and they have bigger, if not the same size screens. Take the XR I'm using example. That has a 6.1 inch display and it doesn't need to fold to have that 6.1 inch display. You can easily fit a 6 inch display in your pocket. At least with the Galaxy Fold, you know, it's a 7.9 inch tablet and good luck trying to put that in your pocket. So I would understand why the Fold would fold, but with the Razr, it's not even giving you a huge screen advantage. It's just a normal 6.1 inch display, except it folds. And that 6 inch display can fit in your pocket even easier. So it almost feels like Motorola, just for the sake of getting media attention for a week, also saying that,
oh, we made a foldable smartphone.
They went ahead and dropped the Motorola Razr, and that is the biggest problem because it doesn't give you more screen real estate for the price you're paying and also what you're getting for that price. Okay, yeah, the OLED screen flexes, the pixels move around, wow. But then what do you get out of it? You can get the same 6.1 inch display. You can get a 6 inch display on a $700 iPhone 11 and have better specs, better cameras. And by all means, the Motorola Razr is a mid-range Android smartphone. It's just the foldable technology that makes it so incredibly expensive. This thing starts at around $1,500. That's like around 1,40,000 rupees here in India. And all that for what? A 6.1 inch display that can fold so you can put that in your pocket a little easier. And on the inside, you just have mid-range smartphone specs. You got a Snapdragon 710 chipset with 6 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of storage, which is by all means competing with like OnePlus phones, like $500, $400. It literally has the specs of a $400 phone. Or heck, you can get the Redmi 7 Pro if you've heard of that. And that has the Snapdragon 710 on it. Guess the price of that? $200, yeah. So basically you're getting a smartphone that is probably worth $400 without the folding mechanism. However, just so you can fit that in your pocket a little easier, you have to pay $1,000 more just to fold and, you know, fit the phone in your pocket easier. Wow, what an innovation of price tags. And that's not even taking in the disadvantages of folding smartphones in the first place. You lose water resistance. And also, if you're still gonna make the argument that you can fit it in your pocket a little easier, just think about the thickness. When you fold it up, you're gonna have a phone that's double the thickness as before when you put it in your pocket, so it's gonna budge out even more. And also, has anyone mentioned the size of the battery on this thing? This is an Android smartphone that has a 2500 mAh battery. That is a little bit of a problem, you know? And also not being able to feel glass when you touch the screen of the phone, you know? Another classic trait of a foldable smartphone. Obviously, glass can fold, it'll snap in half, so they have to use plastic. And at this point, I think foldables are a very small market. They need to grow a little bit into a more mature point where it's actually worth buying a foldable, because this thing costs $1,500 for what? A mid-range phone? And yeah, personally, I wouldn't buy it. I'm not a fan of this Motorola Razr. Anyways, short video, I know that. This is Yaakov Shipio, and any phone is foldable if you're strong enough. Bye.